Hello, this is Bowling Green BMX here, and I am going to show you how to re-grease the bearings in an open bearing rim. What you're going to want to do is you're going to want to take it off your bike, of course, and then you're going to want to take all the retainers and stuff, and just pull them off. They screw off pretty easy. Unless you have them really tight, then they don't screw off easy, which is kind of obvious. But just take it off. It's gonna take a while because it's such a fine thread. But it's almost off. Almost. And it is off in five. Fuck it. And there is what comes off. Retainer. It's curved on one side to fit the curvature of the bearings. And then over here it's just flat. Set that to the side. Then you're gonna want to lift your wheel up like this. And you're just gonna want to pull your axle out nice and slow. Bearings already coming off mine. Gonna want to set out a piece of paper towel or something, which I would do now, maybe, if I can get a paper towel. And then gonna want to put your bearings on that so they won't get lost. Probably good to put all your parts on there, but and then paper towels right there, and then you take a screwdriver and just kind of pop out the retainer. And a lot of bearings will fall out. And then you just take the screwdriver and kind of poke them around until you get them all out. And that should be it on that side. And then you turn it around. And do the same thing. Pop the retainer out. Scoop out the bearings. And this side's out. And then you got a rim. No bearings in it now. You're gonna want to get another piece of paper towel. I usually use a degreaser too, but I'm out of grease, and you're gonna want to, or degreaser, and you know, clean inside there really good. Clean all the old grease out. Make it look all nice and pretty. Flip it around, repeat, and then that is clean-ish. Put that aside, throw it away or something. And now, you're gonna want to move your paper towel, set your rim down, and you got all these little bearings right here. Oh, damn it, camera doesn't reach. Right there. Kind of. There we go. Right there. My tripod's a bitch. So it's right there, and it's gonna be a little crooked for you, but you're gonna wanna get another piece of paper towel, little one. You're gonna wanna pick up your bearings and clean them one by one. Doesn't take long. Just, you can even pick up a lot of them, two or three, and just throw them around in there. And they'll clean right up. These bearings are almost brand new. And bike shop's stupid. They gave me a few different size bearings. I just noticed that. And so, you're gonna clean all of them. And I'm just not cleaning them very good because I just put, these bearings are only a few months old. Not even a month old yet, I think. So I'm not gonna clean them that well because they're not that bad of a condition. So yeah, usually I would soak them in a degreaser, but don't need to because they're not in bad shape. And yeah, and I got four more left, and then the last two, one. Two. And that's done. Now take more paper towel, take your retainers, and then you're going to want to clean the shit out of those, because they're pretty gunky. And then cleaning it right there. Very boring video, but teaching you how to do it. Clean that out. Paper towel goes in the trash. And get another piece. And then you're gonna clean your axle. And then you're gonna clean your the bolt here on this side. Oh shit. Just dropped a bearing, so hold on a minute. See if I can see it. Well, I lost the bearing, so just gonna have to go one short, but it shouldn't hurt anything, because I've done it before. So you got your bearings, motherfucker, and then you're gonna clean up everything. And then, I prefer to use two different types of grease at once. Got it. I use two different types of grease while I'm doing this. I use just regular wheel bearing grease. That's what it's called. And then I use Pactool Polylube 1000. It's a high performance, and it's waterproof. This little tube costs $7, and I'm about ready for another tube of it. But now we're gonna take your rim here and get to where you can see that. I'd help if I flip my screen so I can see what you see. That's better. Now I'm gonna take your polylube, gonna take it, and you're gonna put it all around where the bearing sit. Just all around in there. Be sloppy with it. You can wipe it off if you want when you're done. And then there's that. And now I'm gonna split my bearings in half, so I make sure I have an even amount in each side. Doom. And there should be a specific amount. 2, 3, 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Wait, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 10, 11. So that one needs 2, and that one needs 1. So, got them split up into 2 piles, 1 pile for each side. I've got 12 on each side there. I think there should be 13, but I'm missing some. So, you're gonna take them, you're just gonna pack them into that grease nice and easy. Just go right in, and you just pack them in. Stick them up against the wall, and the grease will come up around them. If you're a pussy and you don't like to get grease on your hands, make your bike shop do this. It's a lot. It's really messy. Shit, almost dropped that one. And then missed. classes. Okay, so that should go like that. Boom, boom. Almost done. Got 3 more on this side. Make sure your bike shop gives you the right size for your wheel too. But I prefer closed bearings, but this is the rim that I had. I got it. Oh shit, nope. Fuck. That bearing just fell down inside. Oh, I found a couple bearings in there. And I just dropped them. Get the stuff. And I don't know where they went. Damn it. Huh. And oh, there's one more. That'll be good. That's what I need. If you can't get a hold of something that falls in there, just stick your finger in a little grease. It'll get it right off the wall. There we go. Should have 2 more than what's in there, but it's not gonna make a big deal. As long as you space them out somewhat evenly. Then you take your poly lube again. What the fuck is that? Oh, my neighbor's garage door. Poly lube on top. All over the top there. And then the axle. You're gonna wanna lube up your axle. Take the regular wheel bearing grease, get a big glob of it on your finger, and grease the center of the axle. All nice and greasy. Completely cover it. You can never have too much grease, especially when it's metal on metal contact. So, take it, all greased up. Drop it through. Don't catch any of the bearings. Oh, never mind. Don't do that yet. I'm retarded. Sorry about that. I'm just really retarded, apparently. Tired. Up at the park, riding all day. And, it rained like crazy, so that's why I'm doing this, because I didn't have waterproof grease in there in the first place. But I found it, because I couldn't find it last time I re-greased these bearings. So I found it the other day, and it's going to work. So bearing retainer, don't forget it, like I just did, and stick it in there. Damn it, I just put it in upside down. Stick it in there. And then, take your axle. Stick it in. And now, flip it over. And you're gonna pack them on this side, same way. Gonna take the grease. Squeeze it all in there. Room 5. On my radio. My bad. A little bit of grease on my finger so I can pick up the bearings. Pack them in. A little more grease on your finger. I just put grease on my finger so I can grip the bearings without having to squeeze my fingers on them, because I got big fingers. Some of you little and girly guys got all the little girly fingers and shit. Ought to be able to do this without greasing your finger. But you can only use the brown grease on your fingers, because the green waterproof stuff won't stick. And then you put your retainer. And then that's in. And now you screw on this end piece here. Which takes forever because the threads are so small. You gotta hope you don't lose any bearings while you're doing this.
Gals, if you want to know if your new relationship is going to last, experts say the ones to ask about it are your girlfriends. Not your parents, not your male friends. Evidently,
and you keep screwing that till it's in, whether or not a relationship is going to last, which takes forever.
WOVO. Hey there, Dale Jr. here.
Still going.
Around my place, I depend on this truck to get things
still
done.
Still going.
That's why I depend on Quaker State Defy to help
still
keep it
going.
Quaker State Defy.
Still going.
So while your odometer will keep on spinning,
still going, and it's almost there. Now it's pushing the bearings out into the grease, and it is in.
The refreshing taste of iced tea. Twisted Tea wants to know. After mowing.
Oh yeah, that's much better. It actually rolls now.
Think about that same.
It was squealing and squeaking because of the grease. So, got that now. You have a little retaining nut, which came off with it, that I didn't show you in the video because I had already started before I had the idea, ooh, I'll make a video. So, you screw that on, I take my, since it's flat-sided, I just take my hand and I run it like that, and it does it really quick. Because you have, like, a whole bunch of turns and one. Okay, that doesn't wobble. And now we do that. Tighten it up, make sure.
Believe it.
It rolls nicely.
You, stay with one State Farm agent.
You want to have it, have your things as loose as you can without wiggle. So you're going to grab it and see if it wiggles. If it does, tighten it up just a little bit by a little bit till it doesn't wobble, because otherwise it won't spin nicely. So that's in there now. And we're pretty much done. Take a paper towel, wipe your rim down, clean everything, all the grease that's extra, clean that off, both sides. And then all that's left is to put it back on your bike, which is very simple. And you must know how to do it because you got it off of your bike. So, that's how you rebuild it. Well, I just greased it, but if you rebuild it, you just put new bearings in. And that's what I did, and yeah. Bye.